Hello, everybody. It's Saturday, and the theme this week is dating. So, I thought I'd give a few tips. A few dating tips. For whores. Okay, for getting a date, you need to forget about the outer appearance, and you need to look at something else. You need to look deeper and see how much money the person makes. If he makes a lot of money, you go for it. You go for it. Age, what he looks like, all that doesn't matter as long as he's got the cash. Right? That's how you do it. Okay. Okay, so first of all, one of the most important things is dress. And you want to dress skanky. Tight clothes. Very tight clothes. Show as much skin as you can. You know, give him a little preview for what he's going to get. Yeah, and so, I suppose something like either short shorts or ridiculously tight jeans, something very flamboyant, something very look at me. Okay, once you're on this date, there's a couple things you have to do depending on where the date is. The common date is dinner. Now this can be kind of tricky because you're like, oh, dinner's boring. So, but there are tricks. First of all, you want to order the most phallic thing on the menu. If it's a casual date in a cafe, see if they offer any fruit. You can get like a banana casual in the park. Maybe you want to like order a hot dog, something like that. You're going to want to order a drink that has lots of foam on it. And you just accidentally get some on your lip, and you're slowly going to want to. Okay, remember, attention to the mouth and eyes, and package. Okay. Now, if you're starting to lose interest, or if there's another whore next table trying to take your check, what you're going to want to do is take some desperate action. Whatever you're eating, accidentally spill on your shirt and be like, oh no! And then just rip your shirt off. Just rip it off right there in the restaurant and be like, oh, how am I ever going to get this out? And just be looking at it, sitting there with your shirt off. Make sure you're flexing when you're sitting here. So just... Okay. And that should get the attention back to you. If that doesn't work, accidentally spill something on your pants and... Okay, when the pants go flying, what you need to do is keep an eye on where they fall, because that's where the wallet is, which is an important part, because the next day, what you gotta do if this doesn't go as well as you want, as in he doesn't have as much money as you want, you get that wallet and as much expensive shit as you can find, and you just get out of there. Yeah. Much love you do. This has been Dating Tips for Whores. Thanks for watching. I don't date, and when I do date, it's going to be awful, because I'm going to be such an awkward dater. I'm going to be like, so how about that weather? It's very sunny and stuff today. It's going to be awful. Oh, I felt so bad for my future self and my future dates because, well, maybe they'll get a laugh about it. I want somebody who can laugh at me and not just like get pissed and be like, oh, the sex better be good. Because, you know what? You're not getting sex. No, not for me. I don't put out, I'm the only prude gay guy. Well, I'm sure there's more, but my friends describe me as being the only prude gay guy. Because I am. I'm not prude. I'm just... oh god, I'm prude.